Yeah.
Take this out.
Hello. Hello, what's up? Hey everybody, it's me, Armando Romero Show. I'm Armando Romero. This is my show, SHOW Show. For those who cannot pronounce my name. Anyways, what's up everybody? It's been a busy day today for me. Because one, I had to go to the chiropractor. Then I had a school meeting. Then I had to go see my psychiatrist. Today is the day when I released my Collab video. Last time I asked you, the viewers, to send me a video at armandoromeroshow@gmail.com telling me about the most outrageous excuse you've ever heard or said. Except not a lot of you said any. Only one said one. Yeah. The Collab video that was sent to me was from a guy named Chris Walker. As I assume that's his name, because when he sent the video was titled Chris Walker. If that's not his name, then I'm an idiot. But then again, who can blame me in this economy? Yeah, he sent me one, and he told me this is the most outrageous excuse he's ever heard or said. Of course, he said that he heard it. And then he found out that it was true. Something like that, yeah. Here's the Collab video, and I will put an annotation in the video so you can check out this guy's YouTube. And his YouTube will be in the description bar.
The most ridiculous excuse I've ever heard is actually my dog ate my homework. I cannot even tell you how many times people have literally said that at my school. I'm not even kidding. Like, they literally do. And then I actually find out that the dog actually ate the paper. I'm not even kidding. It's probably really cheesy that I'm saying this, but I'm not even kidding.
So, Chris, the most outrageous excuse you've heard is that a dog ate somebody's homework. Now, that is very outrageous, and I'll tell you why. Why? Because that expression has been used so many times as a joke that it's become just a simple joke. Is nobody really takes it seriously no more. But when somebody does take it seriously, it's kind of weird. But then it's not really hard to believe. Outrageous as it is, yes, it is outrageous. It isn't really hard to believe. Mice. They seem cute. But in reality, they're monsters. Pure, terrifying monsters of destruction. Mice. I have two white mice, they're female, and a female hamster. Updates, I hurt my neck. It was really bad. Then I had to have a better posture. And I'm reading a lot of web comics recently. I'm reading two kinds. Evian, I think it's supposed to say. Furry experience. Updates. Let's just do updates because I'm crazy like that. I have already begun my fan fiction, my new fan fiction of entitled Fate of Tomorrow. It's already up at fanfiction.net. Just search for me, Armando Romero, and my two fan fiction should be up. And of course, it's not completed yet. Chapter 1 is up, and then I'm also working on the Luigi 2, which will be up around next month or November, I don't know. Seriously, today's been so busy and so hot that I can't focus my mind on saying anything interesting, anything funny, because we all know this show ain't funny. So yeah, that's all I got to say today, and yeah. The finished video will have, you know, I've done a lot of bloopers and things that I shouldn't have said, but I said them anyways. Well, John, I'll see you on Thursday. Mice. They seem cute, but in reality, they're monsters. Pure, terrifying monsters of destruction. Now, hamsters, they're cute. They're lovable. They don't do anything bad. They're innocent. They're so kind. It's unbelievable. Right? Yeah.
Thank you, Andrew Romero Show.
For those who cannot pronounce my name.